Bryant with Texas Constantine. I'm here with Tyler Bryant. He'll be at Anton's tonight in Beaumont, Texas. My first question is, what's up with the radio that's on stage?
My dad gave me that radio. He found it in this old antique shop in Texas. And, you know, every time I load into a venue, someone always says, what's the radio do? What are you going to do with that? I was like, oh, yeah, that's my secret weapon. They're like, oh, what's it do? It does nothing. It just sits up on stage. It's sort of, I wrote this song called Don't Take My Radio. It's about, you know, holding on to things you believe in, kind of. And that radio just kind of goes everywhere with us.
It's kind of like a mascot for the band.
Yeah, it's a mascot for the band. It just sits on stage and, you know, it's there every night. It's something that never changes. Because everything always changes when you're on the road. So it's nice to have a few things that are always there.
And here's a question I have. For, you know, bands always have trouble on the road with, like, accidents and what they had late. Like, have you had any, like serious accidents?
No, I mean, our van's broken down twice in the last week, which has been a pain, but nothing serious. You know, no one's been injured. We're all good at rolling with the punches. You know, we just take it day by day and take the hits as they come.
When's the first album coming out?
Hopefully the end of August. I've been writing songs for the last year and a half, 2 years. I moved out when I was 17, and moved to Nashville and just started writing songs. And we've just been working on this, it's an EP, and it's gonna have 7 or 8 of my very favorite songs on there.
What's your favorite song to play live?
This song called Where I Want You. It's just a rocker, it's fun.
And you write your own songs?
Yes, sir. I write all my songs, and, you know, I co-write a lot of them with my friends back in Nashville. I write a lot of them on my own, just a fan.
And do you have any words for people who want to play guitar? You know, for starting out?
Totally, just practice. You know, it's all about listening to the music. A lot of times people just want to pick up the guitar and like, oh, that, you know, it sounds right. But it's just, you got to listen. And, like, I used to put my ear right up to the speakers and, you know, feel the vibrations and, you know, just practice as much as you can. My mom used to think something was wrong with me because I never came out of my room. I just sit there and play guitar all the time.
And do you have any words for people who are playing in bands right now but are struggling because of the economy? Remember backing out of a band?
You just gotta, you know, you gotta stand up for what you believe. If you believe in something, stick with it. Because, you know, Nancy Wilson from Heart told me, she's like, you know, there's going to be times where everything's good, and there's going to be times where it feels like everything is wrong. You know, and we've gone through that a lot, where it's like, oh, yeah, we've got this, and we've got this, and then we've got times where we're sitting at home going, what are we doing here? You know, and that's where the music has to be enough for you, because if the music's not enough, then, you know, if you find yourself spinning your wheels, you're going to wonder what to do next.
And I heard you got this new DVD out.
Rock Prophecies, yeah, it's gonna come out on PBS, which we're really excited about. Yeah, they started filming that documentary probably 2 years ago, and so I was still living back home with my family in Texas, and I was a little blues addict, you know, and that's before I started writing songs, really. And Robert Knight, the guy who films about, he's a legendary rock photographer, shot Zeppelin, Jimi Hendrix, Slash, just everyone.
He's a doctor
in the show. Yep. And so it was really cool that he saw me playing in Chicago at Eric Clapton's Crossroads Festival. And he's like, I've been trying to get in touch with you for months. And
Eric Clapton?
No, Robert.
Oh.
I wish, that'd be cool. But yeah, it's a real honor to be in that film. Because pretty much all of my guitar heroes are in that film. Jeff Beck, Slash, It's pretty cool.
Hey, Christian. Okay, when you started playing your guitar for the first time, like, did you want to play it like a certain artist or pick up your own style?
I met this guy in a music store named Roosevelt Twitty when I was 11 years old. You know, he's this older guy just sitting there. He was playing a Lightning Hopkins song. And so instantly, like, you know, it hit me. I was like, oh, I want to sound like that. And I was addicted to blues for a while. He introduced me to Lightning Hopkins, BB King and Muddy Waters. And then, you know, once I started getting a little older, I learned about Jimi Hendrix and Johnny Winter, and I started wanting to play like those guys. And then whenever I got to high school, I heard the Black Crowes and the Rolling Stones. And that's when I, you know, stopped cutting my hair and decided to play rock and roll music.
And look where you are now.
I go through phases where I'll get addicted to a certain artist and we'll just listen to them nonstop. And then, you know, everyone around me will get sick of hearing it. I'll move on to something else. And I think all of that kind of like goes together to form styles.
And for people who've never heard about you tonight, for instance, like what can you tell about your show? You know, for them to expect you to...
Our show is, you know, it's just a couple of friends on stage having fun playing rock and roll music. There's no telling what'll happen. Like every night's different. You know, we go up there. We normally don't have a set list. We walk out on stage not knowing what's going to happen, and I just start something and the band follows. And it's, you know, there's like we did a show in Lexington the other night. It was just a packed, sweaty rock show. And Caleb ended up like with his drums like in the crowd. And, like it's just you never know what's going to happen. You never know what's gonna break, or
and that's the good type of shows you wanna go see too.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of my favorite artists. I'll go to see them play, and then I'll go see them again and see that same show.
And I
don't want that. To, you know, I want it to be something new every night, because also I get bored playing the same stuff over and over. So if I can change it up just a little bit every night,
that'd be great.
It's fun to like kind of just be spontaneous and do it on the run a little bit.
Okay, where do you see yourself and your band in 5 years from now?
Well, hopefully in a tour bus that's not breaking down twice a week. I don't really think about that too much. I just try, you know, we're taking it day by day, just trying to make the best music we can. And, you know, hopefully in a tour bus playing to
thousands
of people. That would be great.
And open up for Slipknot one day.
Yeah, that'd be cool. The Rolling Stones.
Yeah. So your new DVD is coming out when?
It'll be out in September on PBS.
And you're going to be like
300 different PBS channels or something like that.
And when's your album coming out?
Next month, August. We're going on the road with Pat Benatar and REO, which will be really
fun. Wow.
For pretty much all of August, which will be fun. But we go out the second half. We're playing the Rhyme in Nashville Park on the 17th, which
legendary venue.
We're really looking forward to that. So
we're pretty much just check you on the road with Heart.
Yeah, well, we toured with Heart last summer, which was amazing. I kind of had a crush on Nancy Wilson. Yeah, she's an amazing player. And everyone in that band was just really cool, and they were really nice to us. It was cool because I met my guys in Nashville and was like, hey, you guys want to start a band? Sure. And within a week, we were out on the road.
Yeah.
And it was like that. We've just been, you know, giving it all we got every day.
Well, that's it. Check out Tyler Bryant on the road this summer.
Yep.
Or check out his MySpace, Facebook, Twitter, everything.
TylerBryantMusic.com.
That's it.
Thanks. Appreciate it, man. Have a good one.